Hell yeah. Here you go. It started. This shit is working. Janky ass camera.
I got to keep forgetting. I got to leave one in my truck with
it. Yeah, praise most high, we even got cameras.
You know, we bummed, so we can't get no cameras.
Shit, I'm going to have to get a new one.
It's private church or something.
They was handing out cups of sugar. I mean, we're in the fucking scriptures of St. Louis and shit.
Do what?
But I'll take their water. Some
LSD water? Oh, they got scriptures on it? Let's read the scriptures.
It's not keeping
up. That was good. Let's read it. See what it says. That was good, though. Let's read that. Because some Christians just gave us some feather water. Oh, man. Is this sealed? Let's examine this. They gave us some scripture water. Hey, bro. Maybe they're really trying to help you. Hey, man. What's that word? I'm being optimistic. This scripture says, those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not be faint. See, they don't know what that's talking about. That's talking about spiritual powers, actually, in the kingdom. In the kingdom, we're going to have power, bro. We're going to be running quick as hell. Get 2/3 on camera. He wants to shine. He over there rapping.
That's kind of the spirit, because I was thinking about spirit. Boom, boom.
At that Fairwood, like, I'm good.
I did. 40 and 31. But they,
I'm starting at 29. He giveth power to the faint, and to them that have no might, he increaseth strength. Even the youth shall faint and be weary, but the young man shall utterly fall. But they that wait upon Yahweh shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary, and they shall walk and not faint.
So it said those that wait upon Yahweh, the Most High. That's us, okay, the elected Israel. So yeah, in the kingdom, we're going to have power, bro. We're going to be like Hancock out here. Like, y'all seen that movie with Will Smith, Hancock? He's sipping wine, flying.
Grabbing bitches.
With
no worry of being accused.
Hell no. Man, we ain't gonna be like your boy Hancock. He was on Uncle Tom. He went to prison and stayed in there. Got clean and sober.
Started some disciplinary shit.
Yeah. Him in adultery. What did he get with a married bitch too or something?
Oh yeah, with a super.
Yeah.
Yeah, she was married.
Ain't gonna be none of that. There ain't gonna be no women in the kingdom of heaven going around and having numerous men be like, oh, our marriage didn't work out. It's okay though, cause we still friends. We still friends and we still respect each other. Ain't gonna be none of that madness.
There's a code. They don't want you talking about them, so they don't talk about the baby daddy.
Yeah. My baby's mama would never be friends. You're not my friend. I hate you. Bitch, you home wrecking hoe. I ain't got no love for you.
I had a weird ass dream last night, man. I was getting along with my kids, mom.
Oh, that's a nightmare, bro.
I ain't spoken to that bitch in several years. What's up, man?
What's all this about?
Israelites.
Teaching the Bible, bro.
Israelites.
I see a bunch of other different Israelite people.
You talking about the Foot Clan?
They say about y'all too.
Yeah, the ones that's wearing the purple and red.
Yeah.
Yeah, them don't think, you know, they so-called Israelites.
I get that Revelation 17.
They ain't our hero. Pushing the truth.
I don't know. I see a couple white guys here because those other two Israelite groups, right. All I see is them just going up to black guys.
Right. That's how you know they don't have the truth.
They told you you was going into slavery, probably, didn't they?
Called you Esau. Edomite.
I said, you know, what's up with this?
Right.
Are you guys like religious group? Like, oh, we're Israelites, and then they wouldn't even really want to talk to you.
Because right. They call you the devil.
They're not spiritual at all.
Yeah.
To them, you ain't nothing but a devil.
Yep.
You
know?
White devil.
A white devil. Red devil, be specific.
Really? You an Israelite? We can tell through the spirit you an Israelite.
I'm Romanian. I'm a Bohemian gypsy.
Israelite.
You know, that's one of the things about the end times. Bible speaks about how Israel is doing all kind of stupid shit,
yeah.
Into all kind of wickedness, serving other gods, all doing all kind of ancient Babylonian practices, and you know, and that's just us going off, because we were all going off at one time until the truth hit us. So we put off that old shit and, you know, follow the truth as best as we can, man.
I've got a scripture for you, because you say that they look at your skin color and be like, ah, this crack ass crack. Hey, read this scripture, bro. Because they, them dudes would never, that's how we know we got the truth, and they got lies, right? Because we know the scripture. Read Revelation 7.
Revelation 7 and 9. After this, I beheld, and lo, a great multitude which no man can number.
A great multitude which no man can number. That's the nation of Israel. Okay, keep going.
Of all nations and kindreds.
Oh, because Israel is more numerous than all the nations on the planet. And we scattered. So read again from the top.
We're scattered amongst all the nations.
Yep.
So you have a son. You living in, you go to Japan, right? And you fucking a Japanese bitch. And you have a son, right? Your son gonna look a little bit of both of them, right? But your son stay there in those lands and find another Japanese woman, as time goes on, yeah, it's gonna look more Japanese.
Yep.
So as long as your seed is still there and you having sons, that's your seed. No matter what that it looked like years from now, it's still your seed. So you're an Israelite. So you, no matter what it looks like, it's still an Israelite.
Alexander the Great was around.
Yeah.
They were mixing in different Persians, the Greeks.
Alexander was an Edomite, though. He wasn't one of us.
Yeah, but his army was Israelite.
His army was mixed with multiple different cultures.
And they just,
same shit that's going on now.
Yeah, same thing with the modern military.
Metal jacket.
Oh, yeah, that's it, bro.
$10 fucking second.
Yeah. That's just a result of this devil nation taking over the lands and their value of all our money. It's like, you know, destroying the economies over there, you know? So you can take a dollar over there and get fat off of it.
You know? Oh, yeah, you believe
that's a sign of wickedness, man.
Yeah, that's true.
That's wickedness, you know?
That's why all them women, because that's really not a good thing, they're whores. But yeah, because they got to. That's the one they call Jesus. His real name is Yahushua. Keep going.
Clothed with white robes.
Clothed with white robes.
Palms in the hands.
Keep going.
He cried with a loud voice, saying, "Salvation to our God, which sitteth upon the throne, and unto the Lamb." All the angels stood around about the throne, and about the elders, and the four beasts, and fell before the throne of their faces, and worshiped God.
Yeah, that's the point right there. So,
go to Amos 9 and 9.
Oh, yeah, that's a good one, too. So, because the point, you know, it said there's this great multitude that, you know, stood before the Lamb of God that was of all nations, all kindreds and tongues. And what that's talking about was the Israelites that were scattered among all these nations that the Lord brought back together.
9 and 9, yeah, Amos 9 and 9.
Yep.
Yeah. This will explain it. Yep. This
will
explain it,
people,
specifically.
Amos 9 and 9. I will command and I will sift the house.
You know about sifting, right? That's right. Sifting.
You ever sift some gold out the river?
Or sifted like wheat.
Yep.
Like when you sift the wheat, you're separating the dirt from the wheat.
Yep.
This is what the Lord's been saying.
Below, I will command and I will sift the house of Israel.
He will sift the house of Israel.
Among all nations.
Among all nations. So he's sifting his people. And some of his people that's going to come out of that sifting going to look like other nations. But they're still Israelites, you know? So like he said before, you an Israelite. You never knew it, but you know it now, though. You know now, though.
Yep.
So we out here to mark these people.
We already know.
To put it in your mind, whether you want to accept this truth or whether you want to deny the truth. So that's why we out here. So when the Lord does come, when he starts bringing calamity and destruction and famine on this nation, can't nobody say, I didn't know. That's why he got the prophets out here in front of the world, you know? We ain't in some goddamn church, in some sorry-ass church. We ain't poverty pimps.
No.
You know, we ain't advertising when we co-signing for them fucking poverty pimps, so we gonna kill them. Yep. Far, when the Lord give us power. That was the first scripture we read when the Lord was going to give us power. The Lord going to give his elect power.
I dreams when I was a kid.
Oh, yeah.
Where there was fire in the sky.
Beautiful.
And there was a flood. And I was running through the dark woods with people that I was protecting.
Right.
And they were falling.
Right. That's bad right there.
And it was repetitious.
You had it many times.
And the Lord liked to be repetitious, don't he?
Yeah, right.
Yep.
Oh, yeah.
So that's how you know it's real. I got a scripture too to back it up.
How you know you're an Israelite.
Check this out. Because right now we out here fishing for the elect to wake brothers up, right? Jeremiah 16. Let me start at 16 and 15. But the Lord liveth that brought up the children of Israel from the land of the north and from all the lands whither he had driven them, because they've been scattered. And I will bring them again into their land that I gave unto their fathers. Because we're not in our land right now, we got some imposters in our
land. I remember reading about in Revelation about the two men that sat there for like 1,200 days in Israel, speaking about the end, how it's coming,
telling people to
repent. Yeah, the two witnesses.
Yeah.
Telling people to repent, and people kept throwing stuff at them.
The two witnesses really represents the northern tribe of Israel and the southern tribe of Israel together. That's the two witnesses, the two different tribes.
The tribe of Judah and the tribe of Israel.
Yep.
The tribe of Israel consists of all those Latin tribes,
Puerto
Ricans, Mexicans.
Because after King Solomon died, Israel got split up into two different kingdoms. One under the leadership of Rehoboam, the other under the leadership of Jeroboam. And let me finish reading this though. Jeremiah 16 and 16. Behold, I will send for many fishers, saith the Lord, and they shall fish them. And after, I will send for many hunters, and they shall hunt them from every mountain and from every hill and out the holes of the rocks.
Oh, yeah.
For my eyes are upon all their ways. They are not hid from my face, neither is their iniquity hid from mine eyes. And I will recompense their iniquity and their sin double, because they have defiled my land. They have filled my inheritance with the carcasses of their detestable and abominable things. Yeah, the Lord ain't
faggots. Hey, the Lord ain't with faggots. He likes
no.
a man that likes a woman.
Oh,
you know, and he likes a man that likes many women. No.
It's the key to eternal life.
Yeah.
If you think of it like that, since women are the door that our key opens the door, you feel me? In a sense,
well, they're just opening
the door to a new life.
That's all they are.
Oh yeah, well they do that because even the word Eve in Hebrew, the word Eve comes from the word the life. Yeah, but a woman is really a man's property. You read the scripture. Hey, you got that scripture? Hey, get that Ecclesiasticus 20:5. I got you.
I'm trying to find this power.
I ain't got my pocket, though, do I? Oh, yes, I do. The women have been giving way too much freedom in this country.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because a man's supposed to be running things, not the woman.
Metrosexual
bullshit.
Like, yeah, that's crazy, man. That's crazy, man. What would you look asking for again?
I got
because you're talking about the women being possessions.
Yeah, I got
it. I'm thinking about something else.
Oh, you just looking at that magazine?
I'm thinking about the seat.
Yeah. Ain't it the 26?
What you talking about?
The possessions.
You already got it?
Oh, cool. I got it.
I'll go ahead and read it.
Sirach 36 and 24.
Oh, see, it's 26.
Hold on, it's 36 and I got it. It's 36 and 24. 36 and 24. Let me read it.
I was trying to find
something else. Here you go. Ecclesiastes 36 and 24. He that getteth a wife begetteth a possession.
Oh yeah, that's it.
You know, bitches only supposed to be out here with freedom and liberty. That's why they all stress the hell out, because they ain't supposed to be working, you know. Going home working, head of household, the whole home is a wreck.
Yep.
Children ain't shit. You know, son's a faggot. The daughter's, she wants to be a boy, you know. That's because of these single women raising, you know, ain't no father around or nothing. While all this is going on, the mom is sleeping with one man to another, you know, on the internet shopping for a man, you know. That's what they do. All those are madness, man. This is all against the scriptures, what Israel is living by, man. It's all against the scriptures.
Give it 5 to 10 years, then the light will show.
Oh, yeah. This, we
oh, shit, the light is going to be those missiles, boy.
Yeah, that's up. Yeah. Right. The light is showing
now. Whatever it is, I'm ready.
The light is showing now, because that's why these people are walking around with no goddamn sense. You know?
You've seen
it. It's obvious what's going on.
I've searched around through multiple different religions. I've even had my palms read.
Yeah,
what did I tell you when you got your palms read? He's like, dude, this is a wise man.
You gotta leave that
like,
shit alone. All your answers is in this book, man. You just gotta be taught how to understand like, this book.
From what I believe and what the lady has shown me, she read off some shit that was true.
Well, no, it's a science. It's like a, how to explain it? It's a hustle behind it. It's a practice.
It's like astrology.
You know, it's a practice behind it. They know how people react. They're going to react one way or another. But anyway, they always give you good news anyway.
It's like astrology.
Right. It's all bullshit. Once, man.
It's like, well, some people might have a little bit of that working with the left hand side.
If you believe in God, you believe that we all have God's genetics in us. And that's our pineal gland. That's our sixth sense.
Yeah, but everybody's pineal gland is is calcified, though. It's orange.
Yeah, because the scriptures talk about that. Stuff like that, and we're not supposed to be doing. Well, you just looking for the truth, but we telling you, you ain't supposed to be into the what they call that
astrology.
And here I'll get you a scripture to back that up. We ain't supposed to be into all that. The only thing we need is the word of the Lord. You know what I'm saying?
See, this will verify the Bible itself will verify dealing with the left hand side is real.
Yeah.
But you ain't supposed to be dealing with that shit. You know, King Saul was. I think he was looking for David or something.
No, he wanted to talk to the prophet Samuel. He went to the witch of Endor, so he could talk to Samuel. He summoned up Samuel's spirit. Actually, talked to Samuel after he was dead.
He was pissed off after
and then he went through all that work to summon him up, and then Samuel cursed his ass out.
Right.
He said, "You surely gonna die now."
Right. It's just it's an example in the Bible. It's showing you it's real.
Yep.
You know, but you still ain't supposed to be like Ouija boards and shit.
Yeah.
You ain't supposed to be fooling with that shit, man.
Oh, hell no.
You ain't supposed to be fooling with that because you're going to wake something up that you wish you didn't.
Yeah.
Because that something going to be following you around 2 weeks later. That something going to make its move on your ass, you know? And that's what happens.
I mean, I believe in like spirits and stuff.
Because it's real.
Ever since I was born and adopted from Romania,
right.
I had a mother spirit follow me.
Romania. Ooh, some heat going on over there.
You
know, ooh, there's some shit going on over there, man.
I mean, you know, like.
So your people is really gypsies or whatever? What they call them? The
gypsies, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I always knew they were the gypsies as Israelites. Always knew.
So I mean, like, it's just a lot of shit that I believe in that I've meditated on and found out, you know, about myself. You know, where I know that, like I call it the second coming of Jesus Christ in a sense, where it's like. You know, not Jesus himself or whoever your savior is going to come down. It's going to be a mass group of people that actually see what this world is coming to. And we're going to stop the 1% that controls this whole world.
That 1%,
they going into slavery. That 1%, they going into slavery. They going to be our slaves.
It ain't really 1% anyway.
Oh, yeah, it's not even that much.
Yeah, it's a fraction of that. Not
even
a fraction of that. We're going to put their heads. Well, no, I mean, the minions are getting slaughtered, but the elite.
Yeah, the elites.
That's too easy of a punishment. They're going into slavery. Hey, get that Revelation
13:9. Take our world back.
Oh yeah, it's getting taken back. The scriptures say the kingdom shall be taken by violence.
Here you go. This is Psalms 149:6. Let the high praise of the Most High be in their mouth, and a two-edged sword in their hand.
Yep.
To execute vengeance upon the heathen and punishment upon the people. To bind their kings with chains and their nobles with fetters of iron. Now the same people that's controlling the world, their future, their very near future, they're going to be locked up. They're going to, you know, one day, I mean, these people never worked a day in their life. They don't know what hard work is. You know what I'm saying? They don't know what struggle is. But one day, these same people that can get carried around, that can they can broadcast a camera on your ass and commit a murder, and they can't be touched. These same people are gonna be locked the fuck up, man. And that's where this is going.
That's just right here.
Like I said, the earth is, look, Job 9:24 says, the earth is given into the hands of the wicked. You know? That's how you know who's running shit, who's not. Israel is serving curses right now. Israel is on punishments right now. So we ain't ruling shit right now.
Hey, I got a precept. I got a scripture to back up. We was talking about those spirits and all that. Leviticus and talking, dealing with those seers and, you know, all that witchcraft and summoning up spirits and all that. Leviticus 19 and 31. Regard not them that have familiar spirits. Now, a familiar spirit is like a spirit that you got with you to be following you around, but you use it to help you and stuff. Regard not them that have familiar spirits, neither seek after wizards to be defiled by them. I am the Lord your God. You know what I'm saying? And familiar spirits, because they're dealing with them spirits. So, because a lot of that stuff, they might be able to tell you certain things, but you ain't supposed to be messing with that. You know what I mean? Hey, get that Revelation 13.
Bro, she told me a lot of shit that is not the surface. Like, she told me by the time I'm 22, something that I've been wanting to know is going to come out. About 3 days before I turned 22, my adopted parents told me that I'm going to be adopted or anything like that. I'm 19 and she told me this. She picked out shit from the past, specific time tragedy. So, you know, I was going through struggles and she said, struggle with this time frame, this time frame, something happened with this time frame. And after,
tell me, go ahead and help me.
Does that make sense to you, though? Yeah. Unfortunately, man, that's some madness, man. That's some madness, man. You can just read somebody's poem and shit, you know? Israel was some crazy shit, man. Israel was some crazy shit.
Hey, they got to put some lotion on me.
What happens if... No.
I get that revelation, bro.
Yeah, but like I said, they didn't...
Yeah, because, I mean, that's the scriptures tell you this thing's going to be right fast.
Right, the left is not wicked. That's the side of witchcraft. It's Satanism, the devil worship, and the right-hand side is the heaven of
fire. Yeah, because we're a nation of laws and commandments.
You know how to take over a government?
Huh? Now?
Yeah.
Right now, we're taking over the government spiritually.
How to take over the government is become part of the government and take them in from the outside.
The inside, outside, yeah.
But what is the word government?
That's not our word, though.
But this, and yeah, because the scriptures, the Lord said that this kingdom was, he said,
how to take over evil, you must become slightly evil. Take over.
Yeah. He trying to be like Darth Vader.
You gotta be 1 foot on one side, 1 foot on the other. So you never lose.
We gotta be on the right hand side only. The right hand side only. You know, the Most High gonna deal, he got those that he's gonna use to deal with that. But those people that's gonna be dealing with that gonna be destroyed too.
The Lord said, he said, my kingdom is not of this world.
Not all of us. 1/3 is gonna make it out of here.
They're gonna die.
Yeah, 1/3 of Israel gonna make it. That's when the Lord comes, when he's gonna deliver. The delivering being saved.
Your body will be destroyed.
Right.
And we're not trying to take this over. All this government ain't getting taken over. It's getting destroyed. This whole country is gonna get destroyed.
Nobody wants this bloodthirsty shit.
Nah.
Blood stained.
Get that scripture
thirsty.
In a number. The blood.
Oh yes, was the foul.
Yeah. And you gotta read that revelation. But there ain't gonna be no government getting taken. You know what the word government means? The word govern means control, and the word meant, where you get the word mental. So government means mind control. You know what I'm saying? So there is nothing good about this government. There's nothing good about the system. There's nothing good about the constitution. None of this shit.
Nature, though, I believe in this.
World. Oh yeah, there ain't nothing natural about government.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? There's nothing natural about this.
It
goes against nature.
Yeah.
Revelation 13:9. If any man have an ear, let him hear. He that leadeth into captivity shall go into captivity. He that killeth with the sword must be killed with the sword. Here is the patience and the faith of the saints.
Yeah, so all these people, because America, this country is built on genocide, slavery, you know what I'm saying? So that's how it's got to end. You know what I'm saying?
You're talking about the government and shit like that. Yeah, I gotta get
go ahead.
You know what I'm saying? This is Revelation 11 and 15. And the seven angels sounded, and there was great voices in heaven saying, the kingdom of this world are become the kingdoms of our Lord and of his Christ. He shall reign forever and ever. Yeah, so that's how you're going to take down the kingdom. This kingdom is by one called Jesus Christ, Yahweh, who will shoot me outside.
You ever seen the UFOs?
UFOs, yeah.
That's the angels flying around. You can look up with some crazy shit flying around. That's the angels and the Lord. They gonna come back to the earth, bro, and they gonna destroy all this shit.
Ever seen ancient aliens?
Oh, yeah, we're familiar with all that, yeah. I mean, they give you a little bit of truth in those shows. But you know what?
Like, there's really, it's hard to believe in whatever religion it is, because, I mean, deep down, you know what you feel is truth. So,
the Bible's a UFO handbook. And the thing about the ancient aliens.
Basic instructions before leaving Earth. Ah.
Yeah, Bible does mean book. That's that Killer Priest shit. Nah, that dude's bugged out. You know who Killer Priest is?
Huh?
Killer Priest? That's where that basic instruction is before.
Let me read this real quick. This is Numbers 35 and 33. So ye shall not pollute the land wherein ye are, for blood it defileth the land. Now this land was tainted with blood. Yep. Blood rights. Over here to serve slavery, and how, while they were serving slavery, they were slaughtering millions, by the millions.
Also killing animals as well.
Yeah, they killed all the buffalo.
Killed them off. That's why they tried to. They actually did. They starved the Native Americans out in certain parts.
By killing the buffalo.
Yep.
The nigga that did that statue's over there.
Oh.
That faggot that did.
One of them.
That faggot, right.
Come on, Tecumseh.
Dude, y'all got a cigarette?
Yeah.
Let me finish this. For blood, it defiled the land, and the land cannot be cleansed of the. Maybe let me start reading again. And the land cannot be cleansed of the blood that is shed therein. But by blood of him that shed it. So in order for this land to be clean, the same motherfuckers that did the killing, they got to die too. So there's a difference between the very people that came over here and did it. They may have used some leprous Israelites to help do it. But at the same time, Edom is taking the blame for the slaughter of the Native American Indians in this land, you know? Edom's going to take the blame for it.
Yeah, they're the ones that did it.
This place going to be vaporized, man, from all corners of this fucking place.
It's got to be destroyed,
bro. It's going to be vaporized. And like you was talking about the other day, man, the Satan 2, I finally saw it now. The Satan 2.
The Satan, yeah, Russia has a missile called Satan 2. Because they used to have a missile called Satan. But that's obsolete. Even though the obsolete one could destroy this whole state, they got a new one, bro. And you see, NATO just set up a missile defense system. Where is that? Was it in
Poland?
Yeah, in Poland. And Russia didn't want them to do that.
Yeah, they're saying they're about to make a move. They're about to do something too. They're going to do something.
Yeah, so
like Russia took it in their new doctrine.
So that's how we know all missiles. The future of this country is missiles. The missiles is coming, bro.
And before the missiles come, it's going to be far worse shit happening.
Whoever's going to be the next president is going to start a civil war amongst
us. Hell yeah, definitely.
And then it's going to allow the other countries to come in and try to take over. And then it's everyone for themselves.
China already buying up most of the land.
That's scripture.
China owns us.
They own.
Hell, we like 3 trillion. No, 3
like
trillion plus dollars.
80% of everything we have and own is made from China or the Orient. You know, Taiwan, fucking Japanese, fucking.
Yeah, Taiwan, that's why all Israelites.
All the Orient.
Thailand. That's why all Israel over there. That's why 3 heathens in all the time. For real.
Hey, all
the U.S.
Jakes,
been over there for I don't know how long since.
Fucking all them women.
I mean, for a long time, man. They know some fine-ass women over there, man.
It was
Tyler,
a pleasure
man.
Talking.
All right, hold on. I got one more scripture for you to back up what you just said. 2 Ezra 15 and 16. For there shall be sedition among men and invading one another. They shall not regard their kings or princes, and the course of their actions shall stand in their power. Because soon...
Race war.
Yeah, there's going to be race wars. It's going to be class warfare.
There's class, rich,
religious
rich
war, all that. You see the racial division out here, and it ain't going to get no better. It's going to get worse. Especially, say, if we even make it to the elections.
They ain't never been good here.
No, it's going to get even worse.
Race-wise, though, they ain't never been good.
Never been good.
It's never been good, you know? They throw that illusion like it's been, but it ain't. Just because a nigga can carry a football or bounce a ball off his fucking head, that don't make y'all brothers, you know? This place has always been divided, you know? Because the funny thing is, like, it's the Irish that came in and took this country over. The Irish came in and took it over. That's how you know they're Israelites. They only an Israelite can come in and take over a whole fucking country. It's some Irish that came in and took over the fire department, the police department, you know, the city workers. The city workers, right? Right, they were slaves. They weren't slaves like the Negroes. They were indigenous servants. And they still got paid.
They wasn't as worth as much as a black slave.
No, right. Even the Native Americans weren't even worth shit as slaves. They wouldn't work at all.
Yeah, they refused to work. They would sit next to shit. They wouldn't even, they refused to eat and drink and say, right. I'd rather die.
Right, there were signs that.
Gandhi.
Yeah, there were signs all over America, man. No Irish allowed, no dogs allowed. You know, just like no niggers allowed, whatever, Negroes or niggers, whatever they put it. You know what I'm saying? But they used to actually put those signs everywhere, man. Esau, the devil knows that the Irish and Scottish ain't nothing but light-skinned Negroes, you know?
There's a lot of the so-called black people in America came from Ireland.
Right.
Like King James was a dark-skinned man. From the King James Bible? Hey, check this out. This is what the Lord said. This is red letters. Luke 12:51. Suppose ye that I am come to give peace on earth? I tell you nay, but rather division.
That's bad right there. Because they teach you the Lord is bringing love.
Oh, nah, the Lord.
Chocolate kisses.
Do you see any love out here?
One thing I'll say, I was born in the Revolutionary War, and I'll end this life in the Revolutionary War.
Yeah, right. That's the attitude you should have, though.
Straight
you
up.
Should want this place to end, man.
Yeah.
You should be tired of living in it. And oppression, man. Oppression.
Tired of this
shit.
Concrete on this floor.
Man, we say that all the time.
Hell yeah.
You know, standing
it's unnatural,
out here, the back
story,
your limbs, your knees, shit.
If you understood why this concrete
rubber
here,
on my feet,
right?
You know,
the reason this concrete's here is because this goes back to Esau's homeland, and he likes to live in a mountainous region, so he turned his whole place.
Where nothing grows.
Yeah, where nothing grows. That's he wants to kill
spirit,
all life, chop all the trees down.
Yeah.
You know, this right here.
Let weed grow.
Originally, this whole area was a forest.
Let the water grow.
I feel you, man.
This used to be all forest right here.
Yeah, it was beautiful at one time. It was beautiful.
I've read the history on it. This used to be a hunting ground right here.
Yeah.
But I got to make my way home, you guys.
Okay, right, we'll be out here the same time next week, man.
All right.
The camera turn. I will turn around, put it on that moon right there, shining. You know, full moon. That's a total eclipse.
Oh, man, that's nasty.
Yeah, that's crazy, man. That's crazy, man. Hey. Brother's got some answers, but you know, want to hang out.
I mean, he's got, you know, he's. Hey, but we gonna.
He's stuck in his mind. You know, he's stuck in it too.
Motherfuckers stuck in their ways. They stuck in their ways.
Mention that revolution that. Be in the right hand side.
Hey, if you might get what you asked for.
Yeah.
You know, say you want to fight in a war. Yeah, go ahead. You might get that. You might get your wish. The Lord said, ask and you shall receive.
That's right.
Be careful what you ask for.
They knew, and Israel do want to be part of that revolution.
Yeah, we ain't on that. The Lord said, I always quote the scripture. He said, my kingdom is not of this world.
Yeah.
If my kingdom was of this world, my servants will fight.
Yeah, right.
And Paul said that the weapons of our warfare are not carnal.
That's right. So we can buy an AK-47 and go hang out with 2/3 and do our share.
Yeah, you did. So the apostles, they didn't walk around with swords just running up on fools, cutting them.
Right.
Like
right.
In the name of the Lord, chop.
Right.
Nah, bro.
When they came to seize the Lord, who was that? Peter who cut the ear off the soldier?
Yeah, he cut the ear off a soldier. Then the Lord healed him.
Picked the ear up and
right healed
him.
And the Lord healed him.
That's right. That's
so what does that tell you about what the Lord is thinking?
It's not on time.
The Lord healed the man.
A heathen.
Yeah, even that, a heathen.
It could be probably a Jake.
Even, you don't know.
It was probably a Jake, though.
But the Lord healed him.
I ain't giving no heathen no love, man. It was a Jake. He probably
you're probably right.
I ain't giving no love, man.
Hey, because a lot of the Roman soldiers were Israelites.
Yeah, that's right.
You know?
That's right.
Zephaniah.
Hey, go ahead.
Zephaniah 3:8. Therefore, wait ye upon me, saith Yahweh, until the day that I raise up to the prey. For my determination is to gather the nations, that I may assemble the kingdoms, to pour upon them my indignation, even all my fierce anger. For all the earth shall be devoured with the fire of my jealousy. Yeah,
I mean, that's the point. Because you're supposed to wait on the Lord. You ain't supposed to be out here trying to tell me, I'm a revolutionary. We finna get it going. You know what I'm saying? We're going. Nah. I mean, you're going to get what you asking for, man. You want violence, you'll receive violence. Go ahead with that, bro. I'll stay right here.
Hopefully, we'll be somewhere drinking some wine.
Yeah, we're sipping on that good juice.
Because there's going to be some of us going to be sitting it out while all that shit, waiting until it calmed down for a chance to probably flee whatever city.
Man, where's that food smell coming from?
I don't know, bro.
Smell that pork smell.
Right.
Smells like Philly subs. Does.
It might be that. The only thing open is that. I don't know.
Nowhere open.
There's a fat taco over there. Spelled P-H-A-T. Fat taco. Oh, fat taco. You don't want that taco.
Let me read this. This is Lamentation 3:25. The Lord is good unto them that wait for him, to the soul that seeketh him. It is good that a man should both hope and quietly wait for the salvation of the Lord.
Yep, for the sake, because we dealing with, the Lord gave power unto this devil, okay? So who are you to take away power who the Lord gave the power to? You know what I'm saying? And you ain't going to do it. That's why the Lord gave this devil what? He gave him tanks. He gave him missiles. He gave him the police squad with just unlimited weapons, unlimited bullets. If the Lord wanted us to have all those weapons, he would have given that to us. You see what I'm saying? So you go fight against this beast, you're going to get devoured. I mean, you're just going to get put down with the quickness, swiftly. And I mean, and nobody's even going to care about you. Nobody's even going to shed a tear for you. Just like, look what happened to the Bundys out on the Oregon Ranch. They're going to have that great standoff, stand up to the federal government. Where they at now? Lavoy Finnegan got a bullet between his eyes, and the rest of them, they all locked up.
Right. Hey, you hear about the women raising up there?
Oh,
some women talking about doing the same shit.
So what the hell are they going to do?
Right. Thinking since they bitches, they think they're going to get some sympathy.
Oh, shit, they probably
come in and slaughter them, too.
They'll kill every last one of them.
Right. Hey, don't be surprised if bitches go out harder, though.
Hey, you might be right.
You know? Don't be surprised.
Because they got that effeminate spirit and they don't know how to control themselves.
Here you go. This is Zephaniah 3:8. Therefore, wait ye upon me, saith the Lord, until the day that I rise up to the prey. For my determination is to gather the nations, that I may assemble the kingdoms, to pour upon them my indignation, even all my fierce anger, for all the earth shall be devoured with the fire of my jealousy.
Ooh-wee. That's coming soon too, man.
That's right. That's a threat too. That's a threat.
So how, like, these fools, how they gonna have a revolution if America's about to be destroyed by missiles anyway? What you gonna do? Like I said, this place is gonna get destroyed by missiles. Russia's fitting to shoot missiles on this piece of shit, man. And that's gonna happen.
Vaporizes.
That's gonna happen.
That's beautiful.
That could happen any day.
That's beautiful, man. We see our enemy actually falling, man. We actually see our enemy falling. I can't get off of that moonshiners, man. If I look that way, it's shining. Shining bright. Hey, maybe that's a Peraza in there. That's their new moon.
I get that Ephesians 6. Oh, I'll get it.
If you, Peraza in their new moon.
Let me get it. I'll read it.
IUCK's new moon.
I got it.
What you want, bro?
Too strong for them or something like that. Probably type of people. Whoever knows that were too strong for them. Somewhere in songs.
Yeah, type of them. Ephesians! That's my work, my Bible, bro. Don't turn it sideways, it'll mess it up.
Woo, me!
Ephesians! looks like it. Ephesians 6 and 10. Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of the Most High, that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. So what's the whole armor of the Most High? It's not Teflon. It ain't a bulletproof vest. That's this word. That's the armor, is this word. The Lord's name is that armor. Okay? Knowing his truth, that's that armor. But peep this. You found it?
Told you.
For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. See, because our weapons is this truth, bro. This truth. This truth is more powerful than an AK-47. We shoot these bullets at you, bro. They go straight through your spirit. It's like Hebrews 4:12 says. The word is sharper than any two-edged sword. You know what I'm saying? It's more deadly than any bullet, any grenade, any missile, because it's unstoppable, bro. You know what I'm saying? You got some armor to stop bullets. A tank can stop bullets, but that tank can't stop the word of the Most High. It said, wherefore take unto you the whole armor of the Most High, that ye may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all to stand. Stand therefore, having your loins girt about with truth, and having on the breastplate of righteousness, and your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Ah! Oh, they don't want to hear that one. They don't want to hear that one. Above all, taking the shield of faith, whereas ye shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked.
Whew.
And take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of the Most High. You see that? The sword of the Spirit. The rifle of the Spirit. The weapon of the Spirit. That's what it's talking about. It didn't say go run up on motherfuckers with guns. That's retarded. Go ahead, though. Y'all have fun with that. Go ahead.
Points at 10, but I'm starting at 1. Psalm 35, 1. Plead my cause, O Yahweh, with them that strive with me. Fight against them that fight against me. Take hold of the shield and buckler, and stand up for my help. Draw out also the spirit and stop the way against them that persecute me, saying to my soul, I am thy salvation. I'm just going to...
No, read it all, man. Read it all. Take your time, too. Don't go rushing through it, man.
Shame that seek after my soul. Let them be turned back and brought to confusion that divides my heart. Let them be a chaff before the wind. Let them be chasing.
The angels gonna chase them. So you imagine angels coming down chasing your ass? You know how frightening that would be? You know how big an angel is? I bet an angel is bigger than that damn building right there, bro. Keep going.
Let their way be dark and slippery, and let the angel of Yahweh persecute them. Without cause, have they hid from me their net in the pit, which without cause they have digged for my soul. Let destruction come upon them at unawares.
Let destruction come upon them while they unaware, when they ain't ready for it. That's why the Lord said he comes like a thief in the night. So you best to keep your garments. Keep going.
And let his net that he hath catch himself into that great destruction, let him fall. And my soul shall be joyful in Yahweh, and it shall rejoice in his salvation. Is the point. Verse 10. All my bones shall say, Yahweh, who is like unto thee, which delivers the poor from him that is too strong for him?
Oh, read that again. That's a good scripture. Yeah, because most people, they so poor, they can't even afford weapons. But they going to fight with a butcher knife. They going to get on them Walmart knives, going to break. Little shit made in China. It might come in, you know what I'm saying, though. But most JK, they can't even afford nothing, bro. They gonna come out throwing rocks.
Make a sling.
They make a sling like King David. They gonna throw, hit that tank with a sling. Go ahead.
Psalms 35 and 10. All my bones shall say, Yahweh, who is like unto thee, which delivereth the poor from him that is too strong for him. yea, the poor and the needy from him that spoileth him.
We're praying that the Lord delivers the poor from this beast. They're way too strong for us. Look, our people ain't organized. There'll never be a revolution. Our people are unorganized, retarded, they're dumb as hell. Man, what the fuck? They ain't gonna, you know what I'm saying? So the only hope you got is that the Most High saves us. That's it. There ain't no other hope outside of that. Go ahead. You got that's okay. All right. Can you think Jake knows tactics of warfare? He don't know shit about warfare. He ain't studied warfare in a day in his life.
You see how the motherfuckers be shooting sideways? Nigga do a drive-by and don't hit shit.
Yeah. I actually know some tactics, but I ain't gonna use it. I just study it for fun. You know what I'm saying? I studied the history of warfare. You know all the ancient formations and all that, and the modern formations. I was in the military too. Fuck all that shit.
So blessed story.
I could imagine Jake trying to come out with a whole crowd of them. They're gonna be all lumped together. You get blown up in one shot. They take their ass out one formation out with one, which is a couple grenades. Hit your ass with that hell rad and watch you shit your guts out.
Here you go. This is Isaiah 14:3. And it shall come to pass in that day that the Lord shall give thee rest from thy sorrow and from thy fear and from thy hard bondage wherein thou was made to serve. That thou shalt take up this proverb against the king of Babylon and say, how hath the oppressor ceased, the golden city ceased? The Lord hath broken the staff of the wicked and the scepter of the rulers. He who smote the people in wrath with a continuous stroke.
He saw the devil.
He that ruled the nations in anger.
In anger.
Is persecuted and not hindered. The whole earth is at rest and is quiet. They break forth in singing.
So we're going to celebrate with the singing song of Moses after this place gets destroyed. Where's that? You know that in Revelation they said he's going to sing the song of Moses? You should read that. You know where that's at? Judith! Do it? Judith 9:11. For thy power standeth not in multitude, nor thy might in strong men. For thou art a God of the afflicted, and helper of the oppressed, an upholder of the weak, a protector of the forlorn, a savior of them that are without hope. That's us. You know what I'm saying? Ain't got no hope. So the only thing that can save you is the Lord. That's it. That's your only hope. You ain't got that, you ain't got shit. And the only thing that can bring this beast down is the Most High. Go ahead. Yeah, it'll get a little cold there. You think it's just gonna be November.
This is Revelation 15:2. What is it? 3. And I saw as it were a sea of glass mingled with fire, and them that had gotten the victory over the beast, and over his image, and over his mark. Oh shit, the mark of the beast. 66.
Oh yeah, the mark of the beast. That's that microchip.
And over the number of his name, stand on a sea of glass, having the harps of the Most High Yahweh, or should be Yahweh Shai. And they sing the song of Moses, the servant of the Most High Yahweh, or should be Yahweh Shai. And the song of the Lamb, saying, great and marvelous are thy works, Lord, so, power almighty.
So that's the ones who refuse that mark. You know what I'm saying? Because it didn't say all Israel's going to get saved right there. It said that, because eventually in the kingdom, everybody, you know, all Israel going to be saved. But when that destruction comes, 2/3 of our people, they got to die. And then the ones that, you know, the ones that overcame, you know, the beast, you know what I'm saying, stayed true to the end. The ones that stayed true to, you know, kept the works of the Lord to the end. We're going to be celebrating, bro. Up in smoke, bro. It's going to be up in smoke out here. It ain't going to be no ganja smoke either. None of that strange fire that y'all be offering to the Lord. You know the scripture talking about the strange, don't offer no strange fire to the Lord.
Your fire 2/3, that's the smoke of your children burning.
Oh, yeah, all that wickedness.
Molech and Baal.
Whew. Lord only knows.
Imagine that shit.
They quick to offer their children to the devil.
He's supposed to be a faggot.
Oh, my Lord. That's a big weirdo.
Yeah. Probably make six figures, too.
Just walking weird as hell,
looks
too.
Looks like your boy, Memro.
He does. He's look like he in the kingdom of heaven right now. Look, I got a goddamn purse, too.
Oh, yeah.
Got a purse. This is a big faggot.
Some Caprice.
Cocaine. You know,
I pray the Lord.
The faggots love their drugs.
Some fucking weirdos out here, man. But people, they good with all the weird shit popping off everywhere. They don't say nothing about it, don't complain about it. You see all these weirdos walking around, all these faggots and transsexuals. Hey, really, you supposed to curse them out, actually. And you supposed to hit them with the scripture and tell them, no, faggots supposed to get put to death. Thus saith the Lord. And that's in the Bible.
LGBT.
Yeah, all that LGBT faggot shit.
Oh, I thought LGBT, demon or devil.
LBT, STD.
Right. Shit.
That shit's getting worse. That's why the federal government just put out, you see Obama just put out a mandate. Of course he ain't go through Congress, but who gives a fuck? I mean, he ain't gotta go to Congress, bro. He's got executive order. He's fucking running shit. Well, he ain't running shit. The puppet masters, the so-called Jews running shit. Esau is running shit behind the scenes. Obama's just a puppet, right? But that man, yeah, it appears that he has all the power. But you see that he passed a law saying that all public schools in America must let children use whatever restroom that they want to. You know, say they identify as a woman, they can go into her room or whatever. What kind of crazy shit is that?
And he threatened them. They know the problem.
They gonna set them off. That's why fuck school anyway, because that's the worst place you want to send your children in the first place. And the most dangerous place you can send your children is a school. Especially if you got daughters, you send your daughters off to a public school, they having sex with everybody in that school. They getting pregnant by the age of 12. They get STDs, getting syphilis and gonorrhea in the class. Where do you think I learned?
I don't know I can stop that shit.
I learned all about drugs in school. Dare came and taught me about acid. I was like, wow, it makes you hallucinate. And then finally at school, well, I got some acid at school. I got acid at school. Oh, you name the drugs, you can find it all at school. He's getting drunk at school, getting high at school. You know what I'm saying? This is the most dangerous place you could ever send a child. Actually, sending your children to school, that's child abuse. Actually, that's child abuse. And then you got teachers jacking off in the, they got caught jacking off in the school lunches. Your children eating sperm. And that happens all the time. The teachers molesting the children, stealing on them, raping them. And then when your children join the football team, they get raped in the showers, part of the hazing ritual. And the coach is in on the hazing because he the one that came up with it. Oh, you want to be part of the team? Ha, 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 ha. We got a little trick for you. And it's in the news all the time about the high school kids getting raped in the showers as a part of an initiation for the football team. I get Deuteronomy 7 or 6 and 7 and 6. 7 and 6. Deuteronomy 7 and 6. Yeah, that's it.
Deuteronomy 7 and 6. Deuteronomy 7 and 6. Thou art holy people unto Yahweh thy God.
Yeah, so we are holy people, okay? We're supposed to be following the commandments of the Most High. Keep going.
Above all people that are upon the face of the earth.
Actually, keep going. I have to ask, actually, 6 or 7, but read that anyway. I meant 6 or 7, but yeah, that's right. Keep going. Now read the rest of it. You already read it. The Lord wanted to come out.
How did I say, love upon you and your children, because you were more in number than any people, and you were the fewest of all people. But because Yahweh loved you, because he have what because he would keep the oath which he had sworn unto your fathers, that Yahweh brought you out of the mighty hand and redeemed you out of the house of bondmen.
Yeah, because now we back in Egypt again, because America is spiritually known as Egypt. Start actually Deuteronomy 6 and 4.
Deuteronomy 6 and 4. Hear, O Israel, Yahweh, our power is one, Yahweh. And thou shalt love Yahweh thy God with all thine heart and with all thy soul, with all thy might. And these words which I command thee this day shall be in thine heart, and thou shalt teach them diligently unto thy children.
So you're supposed to teach these words in the Bible diligently to your children. But when you go send your children to school, they're not teaching the children the Bible. You're not allowed to have a Bible in a school. You get suspended. Okay, you get kicked out of school. If a teacher get caught teaching a Bible at school, they get fired. So that's how you know these schools ain't right. Read that again. Read that again from the top.
Deuteronomy 6 and 4. Hear, O Israel, Yahweh our God is one Yahweh, and thou shalt love Yahweh thy God with all thine heart, with all thy soul, and with all thy might. And these words which I command thee this day shall be in thine heart, and thou shalt teach them diligently to thy children, and shalt teach of them when thou sittest in thine house, and when thou walkest by the way, and when thou liest down, and when thou risest up.
Yeah, so you're supposed to be constantly teaching your children. Teach them the laws and the commandments. You're supposed to teach them all the stories in the Bible, from Cain and Abel all the way to the Revelation. You know what I'm saying? Keep going. You can read the whole book of Deuteronomy. Keep going.
And thou shalt bind them for a sign upon thine hand, and they shall be as frontlets between thine eyes. And thou shalt write them upon the post of thy house and on thy gate. And it shall be when
you're supposed to write the commandments on your post of your house. If you can, you know, print out the Ten Commandments, put it on your front door. So the mailman come, anybody knock on the door, they see the law. Keep going. That's how you troll people with the Lord, with the word of the Lord. Hey, then they can't, you know, they see it. You know what I mean?
And it shall be when Yahweh thy God shall have brought thee into the land which he swore unto thy fathers, Abraham, to Isaac, to Jacob, to give thee great and goodly cities which thou biddest not, houses full of good things which thou biddest not. When thou shalt have eaten and be full, then where is thou forget Yahweh? Thy God, and serve him, and shall swear by his name.
Yep. They're supposed to call the name Yahweh. You ain't supposed to be involved in none of these other crazy-ass religions. Like, you ain't supposed to be calling yourself a Muslim, a Hindu, talking about you gonna go do some yoga. Oh, that's something a heathen, only a heathen does yoga. Okay, only a heathen called himself a Muslim, a Hindu, a Buddha. That's those heathen philosophies. Okay, the Lord said you're supposed to call in his name, You're supposed to follow his voice. They gonna do what they want. They gonna do what they want. That's what they say. I do the fuck I want. It's my life. You ain't gonna tell me what to do. Alright. Yeah, we dealing with Israel. Dealing with Israel, boy, you better be prepared.
Well, Israel tell you they prepare for that day of the Lord too. They ready.
Oh, they ready. I've been ready from day one.
Yeah.
Like I know. They tell you, I know. Yeah. I know I'm ready. Yeah. Oh, listen, you already giving the Amos.
I ain't got to do nothing.
We deal with crazy ass Israel.
They got their name to protect them from Jesus.
Oh, Jesus. Like I call him whatever I want. He got many names.
Right.
You ain't gonna tell me.
It's Israel.
But I know in my heart, my spirit.
Yeah, it's my heart. I know. They don't mention the Lord
in
your heart.
I know my heart.
Yeah.
Shit.
The hell gonna admit they wicked.
Crazy ass.
The hell they gonna admit they wicked. Yeah. fucking snake and a lizard are swerving down here, righteous motherfucker, you know? As long as he's read the Bible, but he's gonna continue on this goddamn wickedness. As long as he read the Bible and loved Jesus, he's good. I'm good. Hey, man, we're gonna have many laughs. We're gonna laugh good when this time comes, man. We're gonna laugh good.
Hey, you know? Look, yes.
That's gonna be cracking up in tears, man.
Yeah, that's one of them.
You know what I mean? It's gonna be some funny shit. You know, certain motherfuckers you know that's just plain out wicked, man. You're gonna love to see their destruction.
This thing, when you hear the Lord laughing, that's gonna shake mountains.
Right. You know, and there's videos all over YouTube talking about these strange sounds people hearing out of space. Wait till they hear that laugh of the Lord.
Wow. Just when he speak regularly, I mean, Israel got scared. We gave him the law.
Right.
Israel got terrified.
When he came to the mountain.
In Exodus?
Yeah.
He terrified the Israelites. Right, so he's like, well, you want to speak to Moses? First, they was complaining. First, Israel complained to Moses. How come? Why don't you get the Lord to talk to us? We don't want to hear you. Yeah. Then the Lord, he was like, okay. Then the Lord talked to him. He's like, no, let's talk to Moses. Amos 5:18. Woe unto you that desire the day of the Lord. To what end is it for you? The day of the Lord is darkness and not light. As if a man did flee from a lion, and a bear met him, or went into the house, and leaned his hand on the wall, and a serpent bit him, shall not the day of the Lord be darkness and not light, and very dark, and no brightness in it? I despise your feast days, and I will not smell in your solemn assemblies. So the day of the Lord is going to be darkness. And the Lord said too, he hates your feast days. The Lord hates Christmas. That's not in the Bible. Okay, Christmas is the high holy day of Satan or the devil. The Lord hates Easter. Okay, he especially hates Halloween and all these other retarded holidays. What you got?
That's something they fucking looking forward to.
Yeah, they look forward to those days. That's what our people's favorite days to celebrate are the days that the Lord hates the most. Check that out. Mother's Day. Ain't no Mother's Day in the Bible. Ain't no Valentine's Day in the Bible. Y'all celebrate all these holidays, Mother's Day, Christmas, Easter. None of them's in the Bible. But then the holidays that are in the Bible, you never celebrate them. Like the Passover, you know what I'm saying? The Feast of Tabernacles, all that. The Day of Atonement, the Sabbath. You don't even keep the Sabbath. So Israel is just totally gone, bro.
Deuteronomy 9:6. Understand therefore that the Lord thy power giveth thee not this good land to possess it for thy righteousness, for thou art a stiff-necked people.
Yeah, the Lord said y'all are stiff-necked people. And he ain't lying. You can't say he's lying. Because that's the trademark of our people. They stiff-necked, hard-hearted, and rebellious.
Deuteronomy 9:13. Furthermore, the Lord spake unto me, saying, I have seen this people, and behold, it is a stiff-necked people. Let me alone, that I may destroy them,
woo,
and blot out their name from under heaven, and I will make of thee a nation mightier and greater than they. You know, this is a nation. I don't know what you call it, man.
A gaggle fuck.
You know?
It's
I don't know what you call it.
Pack of wild hyenas.
Right, which that's a den where the hyenas laying.
A den.
Yeah, and that den is infested with fleas.
Yeah, fleas, got rabies. Hopefully, somebody, the house is burning down. You know what I'm saying? We praise the Lord for that.
You don't hear none of that. Pop off, man. Ain't no motherfuckers gonna get their jobs, man. Only sirens gonna hear motherfuckers that stole police cars and, and fire trucks and shit. Running motherfuckers over.
That's gonna be funny, too.
You motherfuckers ain't gonna be clocking in and clocking out, but a few fools.
Jake already don't work anyway. Jake don't like, well, at least the men don't like working. The women, they fools. The women ain't supposed to work, but they love it, don't they?
Work.
They, I stay on the grind.
They stress the fuck out.
Like, I got three jobs.
Right. You wanna work.
Yeah, a woman ain't supposed to work at all.
Just so they can talk down on you.
Right.
You know, that's why.
Yup. Yeah, act like she better than you. It's just easy for a woman to make money in this kingdom. For an Israelite man, it's hard to make money. That's why they always give the woman EBT Section 8. You ain't gonna see a man get off Section 8. You can get a check in the mail. The only way you get a check if you got that SSI for being crazy as hell. Or being retarded. You know what I'm saying? Oh, but if you a Muslim or something, you come from Pakistan, then you get all kind of free money. Syria or Ethiopia, they get Ethiopians all kind of shit. And they retarded as hell, bro. Coming over here,
ancient Phoenicians.
It's Jeremiah.
Yeah, they had us in slavery. Keep going.
It's Jeremiah 2:19. Thine own wickedness shall correct thee, and thy backsliding shall reprove thee. Know there, therefore, see that it's an evil thing and bitter that thou hast forsaken and humbled thy God.
Every day again.
Thine own wickedness shall correct thee.
Keep going.
Thy backsliding shall reprove thee. Know therefore and see that it is an evil thing and bitter that thou hast forsaken Yahweh thy God.
Yeah, that's an evil thing to forsake the Lord. We're teaching the Bible.
And that my fear is not in thee, saith the Lord God of hosts.
Because, our people don't fear the Most High. They don't fear nothing. You know what I'm saying? They just do whatever the hell they want to do.
Absolutely nothing.
We walk around wicked as hell, not keeping none of the Lord's commandments, committing adultery left and right, fighting for homosexual rights. What happened? Hey, read more of that Jeremiah 2, bro. Get back to that Jeremiah 2. You can read all of that.
You know, it's like, oh man, I don't know.
Give me that Jeremiah 2. Get back to that. Now keep going.
For of old times I have broken thy yoke and burst thy bonds, and thou saidest, I will not transgress.
We've been in ancient times. Yeah, we've been in slavery before.
Yeah, the Lord led us from Egypt through the Red Sea. The Lord freed us from captivity in Egypt, and then Israel was still cursing the Lord, talking about, I want to go back to Egypt, go back to slavery. Tell you how stupid our people are. And they do the same thing in America. They love going to work and working 7 days a week, 500 hours a day.
You take more hours of work, more taxes come
out. Oh, yeah, they take all your money. Because the Bible says you're supposed to pay a tenth out your earnings. This government take way more than a tenth. They take like 30% of your check. And then they take it before you even get it. If you don't pay, you go to jail.
Hey, don't mention child support too.
Oh, your child support, which is not biblical. It's unlawful. Because adultery, most women who collect child support they're whores. And they get with a man, leave a man, get child support. Get with another man, leave the man, get child support. Get with another man, leave the man, get child support. Then she get like,
hey,
she get like 5
to 10. That's
what's
all of them.
Yeah. What is it?
There are some women that wish the men would step up and be a dad and don't want
them. Well, how can you do that when the society is set up for the male to fail anyway? You know? It's a system in place. It's a system in place.
Yeah, I think that man.
You know, things is upside down. Like you're supposed to mention that things is upside down and backwards.
Let me tell you something.
Now, we ain't talking bad about y'all in particular. We just telling the truth. You know what I mean?
You know, how else can these play?
What is so wrong with child support? Because
it's wicked.
First of all, the woman ain't supposed to be. The kids don't belong with the woman.
No, they belong with the man.
They belong with the father.
Only a man can raise a man, for one thing.
Right.
But a man can raise a woman?
That's right. A man can teach a woman how to be a woman.
Yes.
Woman can't teach a woman how to be a woman. No. Can't teach a girl how to be a woman.
Because the woman will turn her daughter into be like, oh baby, you gotta go test the water.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying?
What you mean by test the waters? That's what they can test the waters, mean. You try that man out, you try that man out, you try that man yep. out. All this whole time, the pussy started to smell like rotten rat and dead fish at the same damn time. You know what I'm saying? A woman's supposed to be with one man her whole life.
Her whole life.
That's, her whole life.
That's a sacred thing. Marriage is supposed to be sacred.
Right.
You know what I mean?
But a man can be with all the women he can. As long as that woman can be with another man. And we're talking biblical here. We're talking biblical here.
This hey, let me get that. Let me get that.
We ain't using our hearts. We're using the Bible here. The Bible.
I got
aim on the same adultery is okay.
Where he says comments.
You know, where does it say that it's okay for a man to be with any woman he wants? Besides not just any. Being having any woman, having as many women as he wants to, as long as it doesn't come.
Abraham had more than one wife. Moses had multiple wives.
That was coming back in that time period.
Well, Paul said if you're a bishop, it means you have a church. You can only listen.
I got you.
Paul said if you're a bishop, you can only have one wife.
When is it
so what does that mean about the rest of the men?
I got you. This one, when you call Jesus Christ, said this. With that one that being too fast. You should have.
That's my buddy. So like.
Yeah, I'm about to hop on this bus.
Go ahead. I'll get that.
So you
can say it's amusing.
That was the ancient times, it don't apply to now. Is that what you're saying?
I'm saying times change.
Well, you're right. Time
that's
has
such
changed.
A double standard. Why are men allowed to be with as many women as they want to?
Because there's more women on earth than men.
Right.
So why did the Lord do that? That you're gonna tell me the Lord made us so all these women, if there's way more women than men, why would the Lord make us all these women gotta be alone?
Right.
That don't make no sense.
Explain it. Why do women, in some numbers, in certain states, is 5-1, 8-1 in some states, 12-1 in some places? So how do you explain those numbers?
In China, is way crazy.
No. They ain't no genetics. That's how the Lord made things. That's how the Lord made things.
There you go. This is Matthew 19:28. And Yahweh Shai, or Jesus, said unto them, sit upon 12 thrones, judging the 12 tribes of Israel, and everyone that have forsaken houses or brethren or sisters or fathers or mother or wife or children or lands for my name's sake shall receive an hundredfold and shall inherit everlasting life.
Did it mention wife too? It said you're going to mention, you're receive a
hey, hold this for a minute.
Will
you hold this for a second? I'm going to get this tripod out.
She gone. A hundredfold.
This is amazing. Go on, Peter.
Hold on.
That was it.
Let me get one for you. Let me get some meat for you too.
Actually, I don't think that can handle that. Never
mind. Nah, they gonna take it, bro.
I'll hold it for the rest.
You sure? Is everything blown away?
You should put your bags on the so that doesn't fly.
That's good.
Away.
Here. Right here. So I was amusing, So you ain't never heard nothing like this before, have you?
No, I hear this all the time.
What'd you hear?
I think I've seen you before. I heard with the other guys. Are you guys the same people, the black dudes in the red?
Oh, hell no.
Hell no.
God's sake, no.
So what are you?
Hell no.
We're Israelites also, but we're the real prophets.
Those dudes are,
there's false prophets and there's real prophets.
Those guys are actually suckers.
Right.
They're getting robbed.
Let me read this for you. This is a meat. You might not like it though. This is Isaiah 4:1. In that day, seven women shall take hold of one man. Now, what do you try to explain this?
Okay, taking out of context, what was going on before that?
Before that.
Yo, it was talking shit. It was talking shit by women actually. In Isaiah 3.
Right. That's women. That's 3. When he's talking about women, the foul women of this world, you know.
Cause you know if you have sex with a woman, your sperm gets inside of her for the rest of her life. And if like another man has sex with her, their sperm fight each other.
It actually causes a chemical imbalance in the brain.
That's right.
When they share.
No. That's right.
That's a fact.
That's a fact.
We got doctors that gave lectures on it.
What's vaginosis? What's it called? Vaginosis bacteria?
Vaginosis.
What's that?
Vaginosis, right?
Hold on. Did you just say when a man gets sperm inside a woman, it stays up for the rest of her life?
Yes.
That's not true.
How is that not true? What's
because
the proof?
First of all, the sperm dies and women have discharge that
No. So you don't understand. You don't understand what's going on.
There's three different sperms, bro.
You don't understand what's going on to a cellular level.
To a cellular level,
listen,
cells die off.
Listen, no, they don't. No, they don't.
You don't know nothing about no cells.
You don't know what you're talking about. Because when I said when your man's nutting the woman, it causes a chemical imbalance.
It alters the brain chemistry.
That's right. You know,
hypoorgasm does release certain chemicals in the body, but it is
that's why
sperm doesn't live forever.
Let me read something.
We ain't saying sperm lives forever. We're saying what the sperm
is.
So sperm has proteins in it.
Yes.
It has amino acids
die,
in it.
Right?
You know,
cells
it has.
Not all of them, though. You know, how many sperm?
That's why people die.
How much sperm?
The hell with all that. The Lord said a woman is going to be with one man her whole life.
Have you ever took a biology class?
So do you believe in the Lord yet today?
I'm in biology.
Fuck your biology class.
Cells die after a certain period of time.
But not all cells.
Yes, all cells.
No.
Yes.
You still got cells in you right now. Now all cells die.
You probably don't know what the word biology means.
You made out of cells. All of your cells do not die. Some cells do. Your brain cells, you got brain cells. Some of them die, but you still have brain cells.
Because they split and recreate themselves.
No. Let me read the scripture.
Go ahead.
They're called antigens, antibody generators. You know what I'm saying?
Got it. I don't even know what that means, but he got you.
You don't know what it means, but...
Go ahead. I was just fucking with you. Read it.
But those antibodies is what's permanently implanted into that woman's mind. Not her mind,
he
but her penile.
Came out with notes, bro.
Her penile being from the male. So, you know, especially if you have a child.
He ain't playing games. He used to be a... He used to work at a hospital.
What does it do?
It's the, it's... No, that's the trick right there. The pineal gland releases hormones.
You know, he used to work in the medical field.
I made a mistake. I'm referring to the pituitary gland, not the pineal gland. I had to correct myself there.
The bachelor gland, you know what it does?
Ooh, it's cold.
Tell us.
No, you tell me, because I'm not.
We've been trying to tell you, but you're saying we're wrong.
Hold
on. Do you believe in the Lord?
Hold on.
Of course you don't.
Hold on, give me a second.
It's cold as shit.
I believe in a higher power, but not this.
Of course you
not. What's this?
You're a woman. You're not supposed to win.
I'm not supposed to touch.
You're not supposed to win.
I'm not supposed to.
You're just doing what you've been programmed. Leave her.
Sorted.
Adios. Good riddance to bad rebels.
It's cold, boy.
I ain't trying to hear all that biology, all this bullshit. Fuck all that. I ain't breaking shit down with your so-called biology.
Sure.
Trying to hear that bullshit. Look, that's all I'm trying to hear.
That's a young bulldog.
Yeah, she was a freaky specimen. Matthew 19.
It's cold.
Four. This is all I'm trying. I ain't trying to hear none of that bullshit. Look. And he answered and said, this is Matthew 19:4. And he answered and said unto them, have you not read that he which made them at the beginning made them male and female? And said, for this cause shall a man leave father and mother, and shall cleave to his wife, and they twain shall be one flesh. That's the science right there. When they come together, they twain shall be one flesh. That means, like he said, because when you go up in a woman, you can try to break shit down scientifically all you want. That sperm affects that woman. And you know, when you get laid with that woman, it affects her. That's why a woman, when you have sex with her, she'll start acting like you. She'll start talking like you.
Spirit, because they got the show called Brain Games, and they said, like, you can tell who's, like, a fake relationship or a real relationship because, like, they act like each other.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, right.
Yep.
And they show two examples, like, see which one is the fake one, and the first one was fake, I guess. And they, you know, they wasn't connecting. That's all I needed.
I mean, it's just common sense shit, man. That's why more common sense shit is when these women go around having sex wherever they want. But what happens? I mean, they get herpes. Genital herpes. The majority of women have genital herpes. That means when you go feeling on her, you get with a woman, you start feeling on her, you feel all these bumps and shit off. You gonna tell me that's good, right? Because that's the fruits of a woman having many men and many lovers.
That's disgusting.
A woman getting genital warts, getting syphilis. Always, why you think they got clinics everywhere? Clinics. There wouldn't be no need for that if people just follow the laws of the Bible, which is common fucking sense. But these people ain't got no goddamn sense. So we ain't trying to hear none of this garbage these people talking, man, because they just retarded. We ain't trying to hear your retarded ass shit. You ain't got no argument. These bitches are whores, and their pussy stinks. And that's all there's no debate in that. These bitches are goddamn whores. They all deserve to be put to death.
What the fuck? Look at these niggas.
Yeah, we ain't talking about old women. Did y'all have some background? Oh, you want to kill all women? Are you gay? Are you guys faggots? You want to kill all the women? No. The Bible says that an adulterous woman and an adulterous man are both supposed to be put to death. Woo. Did I read this part? Matthew 19:6. Wherefore they are no more twain but one flesh. What therefore the Most High had joined together,
fuck you,
let no man put asunder. Say, I was too busy reading scriptures, I didn't even hear you.
This asshole.
Trying to drive by and scoffing.
Dropped your pocket.
What they say?
You dropped your pocket.
Dropped your pocket? That's the best they got? Dropped your pocket?
I didn't drop your pocket.
Fucking weirdo.
Man, that's some old ass shit.
Wow, they still.
That's that demon. You hear that demon?
Yeah, that nigga. Bugging. Oh shit, it's all blurry.
He got a demon of Barabbas on him. Just, you know what I'm saying? The Legion. Wherefore they are no more twain, but one flesh. What therefore the Most High joined together, let not man put asunder. So once a woman lays down with a man, they are never supposed to leave each other, ever. Mm-hmm. Okay? Unless this happens. They say unto him, why did Moses then give command to give writing a divorcement to have her put and to put her away? And he saith unto them, Moses, because of the hardness of your hearts, suffered you to put away your wives. But from the beginning, it was not so. And I say unto you, whosoever shall put away his wife, except it be for fornication, and shall marry another, committeth adultery. And whoso marrieth her which is put away doth commit adultery. So if you get with a woman that was already with the man, that's adultery. You're an adulterer. And that's why we're all guilty of that too. You know what I'm saying? That's why you gotta pray the Lord for forgiveness. That's punishable by death. Cause check this out. Sex is marriage. Marriage, people are like, wow, she wasn't married. But because people think that you're not married until you go to a church and go through a ceremony. Nah, the Lord said that when you lay down with a woman and become one flesh and one spirit. Now when you go to a church and have a ceremony and put a ring on your finger, that's paganism. You know, the Norse Viking pagans, they put rings on fingers when they got married. Where do you think this shit came from? Okay? There's nowhere in the Bible said put a ring on a bitch's finger. That's retarded.
And bow down.
Yeah, bow down to a woman. Well, a woman's supposed to bow down to you.
Will you marry me? Supposed to ask the father, not the mother, not the woman.
This whole shit out here is backwards as hell, man. Man's supposed to bow down to the woman. Hell no. Woman's supposed to bow down to you.
That's right. It's an order.
That's an order. And the scripture tell you who. We should get the order. Oh, you already got it? Oh, you getting the order.
Let me get it.
Yep. That bitch over there, that little bitch look like Beetlejuice.
Oh, shit. That is so scary.
She wasn't even cute.
Hell no. She look weird, bro.
It's a nigga bitch for you. This is 1 Corinthians 11:1. Be ye followers of me, even as I also am of the anointed. Now, I praise you, brethren, that ye remember me in all things and keep the ordinance as I deliver them to you. But I will have you know that the head of every man is the Lord, Yahweh Shai. And the head of the woman is the man. And the head of Yahweh Shai is Yahweh. You know? That's why that bitch was up here representing these nasty bitches. Well, she's out of fucking order.
No, as soon as we started talking about the woman, woman came out of the cup, boy. Just,
she got fired up, didn't she?
Oh, that hit home, didn't it?
It hit a nerve.
It hit a nerve. Oh, yeah, you started feeling guilty for your sins, didn't you, you fucking whores? Yeah.
Nasty bitch.
That's the truth, man. You start bringing the truth out and people start getting offended.
She even said she don't believe in this.
She said, I believe in a higher power, but not this.
The higher power.
She said, you know, she said that with hatred in her heart.
Why the fuck can't you just say God? Why do you say higher power? Like, just say the Most High.
Yeah, well, you know, higher power. That's that bullshit. That's that new age speak.
They just repeating whatever.
Well, he is a power, though. God does mean power. Yeah. And he is the highest.
Yeah, bitch. That's what I do.
Oh, shit, I was about to get a scripture. I done forgot it.
Yeah, we took a biology class.
What was I about to look up?
Biology,
what was we talking
class
about?
About women order.
Huh?
Women order and highest.
I'm gonna get distracted even. My thoughts are drifting.
I'm in the air today, boy.
Yeah, say. Hey, go fuck your spirit up.
Wind blowing hard, fucking stuff.
What the fuck?
I know it's almost June and it feels like it's December. It's cold down here.
This weather.
Like a 7 and 8. Rejoice not against me, O my enemy. When I fall, I shall arise. When I sit in darkness, the Lord shall be my light unto me. I will bear the indignation of the Lord, because I have sinned against him, until he had pleaded my cause, and execute judgment for me. He will bring me forth to the light, and I shall behold the righteousness. Then she that is my enemy shall see it, and shame shall cover her, which said unto me, where is the Lord thy power? My eyes shall behold her, now shall she be trodden down as the mire of the streets.
Woo, get trodden down in the mire, boy. Do your ass like Jezebel.
Sorry.
Yeah, these hoes, they got that Jezebel spirit, for real. I mean, that become a cliche, calling bitches Jezebel. Hey, but that's the truth.
Yeah, right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
These bitches are cliches. They walking, talking cliches. They just walking, talking program robots. Programmed by Esau. They do whatever they raised in this filth, and they do whatever the TV tells them, pretty much, and whatever the popular culture teaches them.
Now, Yahushua referred to these bitches as Jezebel too.
Yep. This is Revelation
2:20. Notwithstanding, I have a few things against thee, because thou sufferest that woman Jezebel, which calleth herself a prophetess, to teach and seduce my servants to commit fornications and to eat things sacrificed unto idols. And I gave her space to repent of her fornication, and she repented not. Here it is. Well, that bitch wasn't looking for no repentance.
Hell no,
she wasn't. She's in her kingdom. She don't need delivered or saved from nothing until that. Hey, wait till that time come, man. You think that bitch look bad now, man? That bitch ain't gonna be able to. That bitch look bad. Her hair's gonna be even nappier, you know? I mean, I don't even think she had makeup on anyway. This is just fucked up. I don't know what was going on with them socks she had on. She was sagging. She had boxes on.
Man.
You see that? Yeah. You know? That bitch was confused, man. That was scrambled eggs mixed with shit.
Oh, man.
She should have been aborted, book. Man. Shit. In that case, she should have been aborted.
Shit.
Man, she looks like something out of a fucking...
Not even cute at all.
She's just weird.
Damn.
Well, I mean,
you know, you look at some bitches, you take you fish your mom, I can hit that one. I mean, you know, she's sweet. She's nice, but not that one.
Shit.
I couldn't find a reason in my mind to think she was a lady, man.
Just look how ugly your
kid. I guess she was a female.
Because if you got her pregnant, just how ugly would those kids be?
Oh,
you just pray that your genetics would take over. Like, Lord, please let it look like me.
Right. Oh, Lord. That was a nigga bitch for you. That's a nigga bitch for you.
All right, this is Luke 7:22. Yahushua answered and said unto them, go your way and tell John what things ye have seen and heard, how the blind see, the lame walk, the lepers are cleansed, the deaf hear, the dead are raised, to the poor the gospel is preached. And blessed is he. See, we out here, these women, they got offended. We started reading the scriptures, and they got offended. It says, and blessed is he whosoever shall not be offended in me. son. They got offended. I got.
Shit, I believe in higher power, but not this.
And because they just getting mad at us, bro, because they really mad at Yahweh Shai.
Yeah, not us, bro.
And Yahweh Shai, this is John 7:16. Yahweh Shai answered him and said, "My doctrine is not mine, but his that sent me." That's it, because that's what Yahweh Shai, so really it's the Heavenly Father's doctrine.
Sorry.
You know what I'm saying? And Yahweh Shai, he was sent to teach us that doctrine.
That's right.
That's why you're supposed to follow him and worship him. Yahweh Shai answered him and said, "My doctrine is not mine, but his that sent me. If any man will do his will," John 7:16. Okay. "If any man will do his will, he shall know of the doctrine, whether it be of the Most High, or whether I speak of myself." That's why they didn't know, they didn't accept that doctrine, did they?
Sure.
So they know that they not of the Most High. He that speaketh.
That's them buildings. We just come between the buildings.
Put that down.
If we was downtown, it wouldn't be like this. That's just them wind coming between these buildings.
Shit flying all
coming off that water, too. That stinking ass water.
Oh, yes. It smells like goddamn carp, catfish, and piss shit and pussy.
That's right. How dare you go jump in it?
Go take a sip out of it, bro. Put you in a glass with some ice cubes. Put you a little lemon on the cup.
Right. You'll start glowing.
Oh, but this is America's an okay place, though.
Right. You walk in your, you leave fucking footsteps because it's glowing.
Have you ever seen that scripture?
Leave a radiation footstep.
The scriptures talk of the Lord cursed.
Was
cursing. Was angry about the rivers being spoiled and polluted.
Let me read this real quick.
Let me just get this real quick.
Okay.
He that speaketh himself seeketh his own glory. But he that seeketh his glory that sent him, the same is true, and no unrighteousness in him. Now that's the point. I'm gonna get these signs up before they fly away. Go ahead with it.
John 15 and 15. Let me start there. "Henceforth I call you not servants, for the servant knoweth not what his Lord doeth. But I have called you friends, for all things that I have heard of my Father I have made known unto you." And what he made known to us is his truth, which is bringing out. Which the bitch says she don't believe in this, she believe in higher power, but not this. But not this. That cracked your head, didn't it? Can you see different?
I see the light.
Right. "You have not chosen me, but I have chosen you and ordained you that ye should go forth and bring forth fruit, and that your fruit should remain.
This is crazy, bro.
That whosoever ye shall ask of the Father in my name, he may give it you."
These board, he's just flying around like an envelope.
Just lay that bitch down.
Oh, I got it.
"These things I command you, that ye love one another. If the world hate you, ye know that it hated me before it hated you." That was the point I was looking for.
And for them hoes, love one another don't mean go fucking everybody.
Right. "If you were of the world would love his own."
Yeah, we're not of this world. That's why everybody hates us. Hey, what you at to?
19:15-19.
Okay.
"But because ye are not of the world, but I have chosen you out of the world, therefore the world hated you. Remember the word that I said unto you, the servant is not greater than his Lord. If they have persecuted me, they will also persecute you. If they have kept my saying, they will keep yours also." Oh, that's bad. "If they have kept my saying, they will keep yours also." That's us.
Yeah.
And we were on that order far as the man and the woman.
We the only ones keeping that saying.
Yeah.
Ain't nobody else out here keeping them saying. Everybody else says that shit's crazy as hell.
Yeah.
They look at us like we crazy as hell.
Right.
When that bitch was retarded, looked retarded, talked retarded.
This bitch actually said, "All your cells die. If all your cells die, you would be dead.
You
need cells to live, you dumb bitch."
Man, I'm not even trying to sit down on that level. Because you know that bitch ain't. She don't know how to do nothing, bro. She can't create a human clone.
Hey, that's what the universities is producing, man. They produce that. She's a product of these universities.
She's just regurgitating all that bullshit because of
the shit that somebody shit in their mouth.
Because, these people that run the universities. They teach one doctrine, but they're part of secret societies where they're fucking offering children to fucking devils and demons and conjuring up spirits and doing crazy shit. Look, John 7 and 7, since we's in John. John 7 and 6. And Yahushua said unto them, my time is not yet come, but your time is always ready. The world cannot hate you, but me it hateth, because I testify it. Slog it, let me read that again. The world cannot hate you, but me it hateth, because I testify of it, that the works thereof are evil. So when people come up, they don't hate us, they hate the Lord. You know what I'm saying? And the only reason they hate the Lord is because he's cursing their wicked asses out and telling them how evil they are. Yeah. Them women, they didn't have nothing to say until we started talking about women. And if we got
dogs. I didn't call them bitches
no fucking women. Yeah, they ain't women.
Goddamn dogs.
You know, each one of them probably done been with 50 men each. Whew. They got shit to say.
Bro, that was the last month.
Oh, last month. Well, you know what I mean. Last month, last week.
Shit. They got nothing wrong with that, though.
That, oh, because I ain't married, though. Shit. They think marriage is a ceremony, not the sexual act. Fucking whores, man.
Yeah, bitch.
Might as well get the horror scriptures.
Okay, let me read this real quick.
Oh, go ahead. I'm gonna wrap this sign up. They just gonna blow up.
It's 1 Peter 2:9.
Oh, that's good.
Oh, you know what? Let me start with a little bit more.
Read all of that.
Yeah, I love this 2:9.